systems configurations. In this section, the main system components are presented and an overview of the system's operation is explained. Systems configurations and testing of optical and electrical components are also presented in this section. The system configuration is shown in, which consists of the following components: I, laser source; 2, acousto-optic modulator; 3, fiber amplifier; 4, optical circulator; V, optical antenna; VI, balance detector; and 7, signal processor. Optical components are connected with a single-mode polarized maintained, PM, optical fiber. Coherent Doppler LiDAR systems configuration. Our laser source has two outputs, a low-power seed laser that is used as a local oscillator, low, and a high-power output, 0.5W, that is modulated, pulsed, and frequency-shifted using an acousto-optic modulator, AOM. Electronic circuits drive the AOM to shift laser signals by 84 MHz and generate 200 ns Gaussian-shaped laser pulses. These laser pulses are amplified through an erbium-doped fiber amplifier, EDFA, then transmitted from port 1 to port 2 of the optical circulator. To minimize the back reflection from port 2 back to port 1, the fiber tip at port 2 is angled and polished. Laser pulses are transmitted into the atmosphere and aerosol particles scatter the laser signals back into the lens, which in turn are transmitted from the optical circulator's port 2 to port 3. Backscattered and low signals are optically mixed using an optical coupler. Optically mixed signals are heterodyne detected through an optical balance detector, which generates RF signals. These RF signals are acquired at a 400 MHz sampling rate using an analog-to-digital converter card, ADC, which is equipped with an onboard field programmable gate array, FPGA, to allow for real-time analysis. Digital data is then streamed to a host PC for further processing. More detailed explanations of key components are presented below. The laser source is a distributed feedback erbium-doped fiber laser, DFB-EDFL, from NP Photonics. The laser's wavelength is 1545.2 nanometers, and it has two outputs: first output, used as a seed laser, and second output has an adjustable output power up to 500 milliwatts. The spectrum of the delayed heterodyne detected signal as measured by a spectrum analyzer has a full width at half maximum, FWHM, of a few kHz. The laser line width is approximately 3 kHz, which corresponds to a velocity estimation accuracy of 0.2 cm s-1, so the laser line width is enough for our specification. The continuous wave, CW, laser input is frequency shifted and pulsed through the arms, where an ultrasonic pulse is generated at a piezoelectric device by driving RF signals. Two ohms are connected in series to obtain a very low extinction ratio. Each ohm shifts the frequency by 42 MHz, which leads to a total frequency shift of 84 MHz. The purpose of shifting the frequency of transmitted signals by 84 MHz is to shift the frequency of the zero velocity, so that both positive and negative Doppler shifts could be recognized. The driving RF signals turn the arms on during the 300 ns of the 20 kHz RF driving pulse to generate a laser pulse with 200 ns full width at half maximum, FWHM. An erbium-doped fiber amplifier, EDFA, that has an average power of 340 milliwatts and a peak power of 74.6 watts is used. This peak value cannot be increased beyond 74.6 W because of the stimulated Brillouin scattering, SBS, which can take place when an intense laser beam travels through a medium such as an optical fiber. SBS is generated from the acoustic vibrations in the medium that are caused by variations of the electric field of a traveling laser beam. Usually a laser beam undergoes SBS in an opposite direction to the incoming beam, which in our case can go back to the laser amplifier and cause damage to it. The EDFA has two amplifier stages, preamplifier and power amplifier. Output power is adjusted in a current control mode by adjusting the current of the power amplifier stage. The optical circulator ensures that the amplified output laser pulse is transmitted into the optical antenna and not into the detector. It also ensures that received backscattered signals and signals reflected off the fiber tip from the output pulse are directed into the receiver and not into the fiber amplifier. The back reflection signal level at the fiber tip of the output port, port 2, of the optical circulator is very critical, because it can damage the optical detector. A 4 inches diameter lens with a focal length of 50 centimeters is used. The truncation ratio is approximately 0.88, and the lens Rayleigh range is approximately 5 kilometers, which means that the laser beam can be collimated for all desired range, 100 meters to 4 kilometers. This lens is mounted on an aluminum rail with a fiber holder that houses the optical fiber. A 6 inches mirror is also mounted on the same rail to steer the laser beam, and the entire setup is mounted on an optical table. An in-gauss heterodyne balance detector with a bandwidth extending from DC to 125 MHz is used to retrieve backscattered signals. The benefit of using a balance detector is to subtract the two optical input signals from each other, which results in the cancellation of common mode noise. This allows for detection of small changes in the signal path from the interfering noise floor. The photocurrent is converted into voltage through the detector's transimpedance amplifier module. Detector's noise was measured using a spectrum analyzer while no optical signals were applied to its inputs, gain was set to 1 times, transimpedance was set to 1.4 kΩ, coupling was set to DC, and spectrum analyzer's frequency resolution was set to 3 MHz. Detector's noise was equal to minus 83 dBm, which is 1 decibel below detector's specification of 3.6 pWHg-1/2. The detector has a non-flat gain response, i.e. the gain of the detector varies with the frequency of the input signals. Non-flat gain response of the heterodyne balance detector. To correct for this non-flat gain shape, received signal's power spectrum is divided by the power spectrum of detector's output while no signal is present. The measured power when signal is present can be represented as dividing this measured power spectrum by the power spectrum where no signal is present gives, where SNR is the signal-to-noise ratio. Subtracting 1 from 16 gives the SNR. The previous technique is used in our signal processing to estimate backscattered signal power. All optical components are connected through PM optical fibers to ensure that the polarization state of the electric field of the local oscillator and that of the backscattered signals are very close, if not the same. Maintaining the polarization state throughout the different components of the system ensures a high level of the heterodyne detected signals.